First of all, giving all the thanks, all the praise, and all the glory to Almighty God. Our twin representative, Skid Row, our first Skid Row clone.
You can take a couple, man.
Do a couple.
Do your thing, man.
Okay. Okay, well, it's about spoken word. That's why I'm here, and that's what I'm gonna give y'all. Skid Row flowing. How's somebody gonna tell me what I can't have? What I can't do? I can. I can be that skinny jeans wearing All-American poet everybody's comfortable with too. I can shuffle my feet, I can sing, I can dance, I can act, I can freestyle rap fast. So fast, nobody will be able to enter, under, or overstand what in the world Twin is saying. Likewise, forget what came out my own mouth as soon as I said. I can talk slow and sound like all the rest of them. And you can hang on everywhere and just get impatient. I can be soft-spoken and gentle, or loud, angry, and blatant. I can be your worst nightmare or a dream come true. I can let you win or put my foot down and straight dominate you. I can follow the crowd, be popular, blend in, fit in, speak your lingo. I can flatter you, fraternize, serenade, and cater to your ego. I can do whatever it takes without having to contemplate. I can leave the poetry alone, write a book, and just as much appeal to your mind state. I can hate, I can love, I can cry, I can smile. I can talk about different things without switching up my style. I can write poetry without the rhyme. If I want to bad enough, here we go again. I may as well write a novel if I'm gonna put in that kind of time. I can make myself seem ignorant and unapproachable to you just the same. Express words of wisdom and knowledge, making you dumbfounded and confused. I can write a new poem every day, different from the last. Piles on top of piles. I can be the most philosophical poet on the scene right now. I can talk shit. More shit than a little bit. I can back it up too, but not with violence, with just writing about it. I can, cause I can. I can, cause I'm a black man. Means you can. I can ignore chivalry, sit down like the king I am and let you stand. I can define who I am for myself. I can be my own worst critic, not you or anybody else. I can read reaction without seeing it as a result of my spoken word art. I can tell I'm effective without feedback, cause everything I write, it's from the heart. I can take your accolades and throw them right back up in your face. Big mistake? Okay. I can take that and learn from it as a lesson. I can take what you call a curse and see it as a blessing. I can rhyme at the end of every sentence, still make sense, capture my audience, and make you feel my presence. I can be that poet in your midst like that thief in the night. I can make the rhyme a slave to me instead of me a slave to the rhyme. I can be the comedian, ha ha ha, make you laugh and flirt. I can approach you first, be the bigger man, shake your hand. Oh, you still got a snotty ass attitude? The effect I have on you. Oh, I did that. How? By now, you already know damn well I ain't gotta be repeat myself, but I can. Like, I can imagine how many people who actually know me would actually say, twin, asshole, cuckoo, weirdo, crazy, a poet? So he thinks. And a notepad is my shrink. Can't you tell? I tell her everything. Like I get these flashbacks that feel like the past is the present. Still remember rape. Still remember sodomy. Like it's in my mind now, fresh. Still got all these stitches. And somebody I don't know wants me to talk about it. The effect violence and sex crimes have on a victim, not who deserves it. Like I admit, I love drama, love movies that make me cry for the therapy of my trauma, and I hate you if you don't love my drama too. After all these years I put in writing, just to present at these poetry venues, all the energy, all these theatrical animated gestures I use, the sweat and dedication just to hear that question. Never heard that poem, twin, is it new? As new as originality and old as my living conditions and title that would make exploitation justifiable. Give you a fancy name like business savvy or hustle. What you mean, what am I bringing to the table? In case you haven't noticed, chief surgeon over this operating table, not to mention my son Ali, messed it up for us both, worshiping daddy like some symbol. Who defines a real man? My seed says so. Your definition? Inconclusive, sexist, and illogical. Mission impossible for any male or female to grow into a man or woman without struggle. Now, hell has no fury like the jealousy of my son's mama. She miserable. Physically fit don't mean fit for survival. It's mental. Only then words work and become motivational. Like the difference between substantial content and nursery rhyme scribble. Full-grown convict already doing time in prison when I finally discovered a pen as my pistol at gunpoint. Isolate the homicidal, become hero to the suicidal. I don't spill it out, it flows like my soul. It's natural, nothing commercial. Ain't selling egos like them personas of the socially influential. Shame on me. And shame on you for buying into that fashion show. So no, you don't have to get it or dissect this message. Not a rapper, not a comedian. I'm selling a poem. Not just a poem, or the realest poem I ever wrote. Like most of my work, you just heard it. Some good old spoken word poetry. I'm gonna do one more, and I wanna hear some of y'all.